In this video, we'll use Quick Surface to create a CAD model of the port, starting with the mesh that we prepared in the previous workflow. Let's open the file Port Scan 2 from the recent documents list. The model should still be in right-gview from when we last saved it. We'll start in the Reverse Manager. To begin, we'll right-click the mesh and choose Quick Surface. This opens the mesh in the Quick Surface program window. The tan shape represents the mesh. We can choose New Freeform to create the surface manually, or we can surface the mesh automatically using Auto Surface. We'll choose Auto Surface. In the first step, we'll choose the target quad count and the level of feature details for the surface. The default values, medium and balanced, typically produce good results, so we'll choose the preview button to see what the surfaces would look like. The orange shape represents the surfaces, and the curves represent the surface boundaries. As we would expect, the results look reasonable using the defaults. If we choose the tolerance display, we can see how closely the surfaces conform to the mesh. Let's choose a low target quad count and low feature details and preview the results. These settings produce fewer surfaces, but they also create a hole in the model. In addition, the tolerance display shows large deviations between the surfaces and the mesh. Finally, we'll choose the fine and higher settings and preview. Here, we see better symmetry, but a more complex model, as the surfaces follow the mesh very closely. Let's clear the result and choose the medium and balance settings. We'll then enable draw guide curves and draw a curve along the mesh to influence what we'd like to be a line of symmetry in the model. We'll then rerun the preview. We now see a more symmetric set of surfaces. The results using guide curves are subjective, and since we want to follow a repeatable workflow, we'll clear the curves and choose preview before continuing. When we choose OK, we see both the mesh and the surfaces. If we double-click the model, Quick Surface opens the Edit Surface dialog and displays the quads used to define the surfaces. There's a slight irregularity in the quads, but overall, the pattern is smooth and even. We could use a short guide curve to even out the quads, but we'll continue using the default values. If we need to adjust the quads, we can change the relative transparency between the mesh and the surfaces to see how they conform to one another. In this case, no changes are required because of the care we took in preparing the mesh. We can use the tolerance display to show the deviations between the mesh and the surfaces, as we did in the preview phase. We can also use zebra rendering to help gauge smoothness. In this mode, uneven lines indicate a lack of smoothness. If we choose the Brush Smooth tool, we can adjust the nodes to smooth all points or only the convex or concave areas. The effective smoothing is displayed in real time, and we typically want to take one or more passes using the lowest smoothing strength. If we're not satisfied with the results, we can use Ctrl-Z to undo the smoothing. Let's choose Back to return to the Edit Surface dialog, and then choose Close. When we choose Open in Verisurf, the surface model is transferred to the active level in Verisurf. If we hide the mesh, we can see the surfaces. This completes the surface model using Quick Surface. In the next video, we'll see how to create a single surface model using slicing and lofting. Let's save the file. To see the difference, visit us at verisurf.com.